Recording is on.
Can see my screen now?
Yes, can see.
Okay. So we are going to start this. Okay. You all got try to do the exercise, this one. Got try see this exercise, able to understand or not the exercise? Later on, when you do all this exercise and then you're not able to understand what the question required, you just ask inside the WhatsApp group, can? Okay. So for this this session, we will start on the supplier and customer order. Then later on, we'll proceed with the bill side. Then we'll see on the back order import bill. Okay. So, this morning you already learned on the stock adjustment and store not. So hopefully you're able to understand. So now we will see on the supplier side, supplier bill and supplier order. I will not go more on the customer because the process is just the same. Just that when we are talking on the supplier side, we will talk about stock balance is going in or out. Supplier bill, supplier side. When we are talking about supplier bill, we are talking about the stock balance in or out.
In.
Because supplier, we buy things, item will go into our store. So customer, we sell thing, it will go out from our store. So now I will teach on the supplier order first. So basically for supplier order, when we key in supplier order, what is the document that we will see is this one, purchase order quotations. Normally these two lah, is the standard one, purchase order and quotations. So what is the difference? It's just the document type. The difference is quotation normally, before we purchase things, our supplier will send us, oh, for this product item A, for 10 quantity, the price will be 10 ringgit. Same item, but if you, let's say you buy more than 50, I give you at ringgit 50 cent. That is quotation. So as a company, when you see this quotation, you will decide whether you want to buy more or you want to buy less. That is quotation. So purchase order is what? Purchase order is the document that you put or place an order. So let's say you already said to your supplier, okay lah, I want product A 50 unit. So your supplier will prepare for you the purchase order and you just key in inside the system for your own record so that you know, oh, actually on this date, I already purchased, I already order 50 unit of this product A, example. So now let's say, we purchase, we make an order. Example lah, I make the order is actually yesterday one. Kejap lah, I punya stock. Stock. Just now kita guna example store Cheng. Now I use example store per ringgit nah. Okay. On 8th of May, I make an order at per ringgit. Supplier, you can choose your own supplier lah. So now, just now the Apple product. But the purchase, 15 unit of this. Remember, purchase order, when I key in 15, will it impact my stock balance? No. So after I save this record, what will be my balance for this Apple at per ringgit? I do these transactions, then I view report, stock cut just now, this stock cut. This I choose per ringgit. For this product, what will be the balance? No need to think lah, customer order no impact balance, zero lah. Boleh ah. As long as order, you tak perlu risau already, dia tak akan impact you punya stock balance unless you pergi change, oh this logic, oh I mau oh, this purchase order impact I punya balance, then baru akan impact. So normally logically tak akan impact your balance. So say supplier order, I terus tanya you, supplier order akan impact balance tak? Tak. So no matter what document you choose pun tak akan impact you punya stock balance. Okay? Regardless apa dekat sini, new ke, pending ke, cancel ke. Okay. The difference is kalau you punya document status dekat sini is new, it will impact the import process. Import process means this order deliver to you already. So when deliver to you, that time you need to key in delivery order. When you key in delivery order, you can direct import this bill, right? But if let's say this document you put as new status, then you won't be able to see this document. Why? The status is new. It's not confirmed yet. Once you change this to confirm, then only you can import. Can ah?
Okay.
Status new, this one? Okay. This status default value will back on this setting just now. Sorry. This set document status. Actually behind got the sorting one. If not follow this sorting, if let's say this sorting is not, we didn't key in anything, 0, 1, 2, 3, we didn't key in just blank, then it will based on our SQL order by. SQL means you need to check from database. If let's say we order the sorting order by the sort this document status, which is the first sorting, we need to check from there. Okay, so just now when key in this purchase order, okay, I open back new one purchase order. Okay, you see document status is blank, right? But once I choose the document type, purchase order, document status here will go to new. Why new? Let's see. AP order. PO. It's because this one is the new, the first sort. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, the other 5 go. Or 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. So new clause cancel confirm pending. Sama tak dengan sorting dekat sini? New clause cancel confirm pending. Sama tak? So dia punya sorting is sama dengan sini punya sorting. Sorry. That's why when you choose purchase order, first one will be the new status. Okay. So next time when you do, for example, supplier bill, added already the bill, but then still not impact my stock balance. You check the product group, set proper already. This one is countable punya product, so should check the balance. And then check back your document. You need to take care the document date is correct or not. If let's say this date you key in the bill, then the balance only affect on this date and onwards. Then you need to check lah. Maybe you check wrong store. So you need to make sure you choose the correct store when you viewing the report. Then next one, all this check okay already, correct one. Then you see document status. Oh, new one. That's why tak ada keluar dekat report. Okay. And you can. Which part you tak faham?
Yang mana kena check?
Yang mana kena check?
So that yang mungkin tak silap, tak ada silap untuk
report. Okay. Let's say you sudah buat transactions. You sudah buat transaction, you check balance still tak ada ataupun just now, like just now, no record. Okay, first one you need to make sure you punya products. You punya products betul tak? You sudah set is countable punya product ke tak? Second, you check document that you punya store. Maybe you punya document that you letak 9 hari bulan 5. Tapi report you check sampai 8 hari bulan 5. Just now here boleh choose report kan. You punya transaction is 9 May. But your report you letak macam ni je. Before ke after the document that this report. This range is within the document that or not? My transaction is this date. Tak kan, dia selepas kan.
Sudah lepas.
Selepas. So bila you place report macam ni, this date is not ini date 9 hari bulan 5 not within this date. So dia tak akan masuk report punya. Okay. Andrew boleh? Next, you choose you punya, you akan choose you punya on store lah bila buat report. You choose peringgit, 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 then baru realize dekat sini is MS store. Kalau you choose wrong store, then you punya report pun tak akan keluar lah. Then, another one is new status, document status. Need make sure dia adalah confirm. Ataupun, walaupun dia new, you need to make sure dekat sini. Ni dia new active. Tapi this one is purchase order lah. Confirm tak ada stock balance checking. Just dekat. Oh, later on remind me introduce you all lah. So kita punya support hari ni. Ada. Okay. Order dia tak akan impact, but bill will impact by this status. Just now, this one is, I sudah bagi you all confused. This one is purchase order. So, automatically, report tak akan affect. Betul tak? This one dapat lah. But if let's say I'm talking about customer bill punya side, supplier bill punya side, is billing punya side, bill side. So, all the things that I mentioned earlier, you need to make sure betul punya. You, the document status, the store, the debt, the products punya grouping kena betul. Okay? Okay. So now, I save this bill. I just want to make sure you all faham punya. Tadi kita just add purchase order kan? I key in untuk bulan 5. Store just now is per ringgit. This product submit no record because the purchase order is order supplier order, so tak akan impact you punya stock balance, will have no record. Okay, so now tadi I cakap document status akan impact, betul tak? So I add this bill, betul? Status is confirmed. Okay. Now, come on 9 hari bulan 5, this order, I punya supplier fulfill this order. So what they will do, they will send us a delivery order document. So you just go to supplier bill, then add new, then start to key in the delivery order. Okay. This step. Okay. I choose different store first. Supplier Sam. Order bill. I import order bill. Means order bill is this supplier order. This one. Okay, import lah. Import. I can see this document. Okay. Actually, this one. Ini tadi I add which store? This bill added on which store? Peringgit, betul tak? Tapi bila I add supplier bill, you see, I choose apa store? Why I still boleh import this bill punya? Different store mah. I order line store sampai line store ke? Supplier sama? Is yeah. One is supplier sama lah. If let's say different, I set to different supplier, maybe cannot see this document already. Okay. Actually this one, kita boleh control by setting. Either you want dia boleh cross store import ataupun let's say peringgit to peringgit only. I order dekat peringgit and then deliver pun must be peringgit. Okay, this one ada checking, ada setting. Let me see. Sorry, AR pula. This one later on, I check the setting first lah. I can't remember dekat mana itu setting dia set untuk filter store dengan supplier. Actually, this two, dia boleh cross import. Tapi pun kita boleh set, kalau I set peringgit, kalau I set MS store, then I tak nampak this bill is due to, this bill is belong to another store. That one later on, I akan share dalam itu WhatsApp group. If you ada masa, you boleh try. Okay. Okay. So now, I tak mau dia pergi MS store. I akan change back to peringgit. Okay. Okay, now import this one. Untuk import, dia ada two ways import. One, you boleh terus klik dekat sini. So that one, you just can choose one bill at a time. Another one is you tick dekat sini. If let's say you ada 2-3 purchase order. So you boleh tick which one that you want to import. Okay. Kita add satu lagi. Apa dia macam a bit slow. I add another one on this step punya 9.5 RM. Teringgit juga. This time I order 20 unit of this apple for this reference number 0312. Just now when import, just one bill kan? You boleh nampak. Now you can see the two bills already. If this debt, I letak keluar satu bill saja. Why? Sorry? Yes, the two order bill is different. That one is on 8, another one is on 9. So when I do import, I do delivery on 8. When I want to import, of course, when on this date, the PO 0312 belum exist because the date is 9 of May. Kena? This one saja yang you nampak because the debt is on 8. This one tak nampak because the debt is on 9. So, if let's say supplier bill, here I put 8, I just nampak 311. If I change this one to 10 on 9 lah. Then I able to see back this one already. So just now I cakap kalau you more than one document you can tick here, then click import selected. Otherwise we just tick tekan dekat sini. Okay. So for this one I import both. Import selected. So what will happen to my entry? Dia keluar dua produk. Dua produk raw. Why two products raw? Same products mah. Kenapa kena keluar sampai dua kali? It's because of this one is belong to this order. Another one is belong to this order. Different order. Faham? Okay. So now for PO0311, I order 15. So when import akan automatic keluar as 15 because I order 15 mah, I import from the purchase order. Okay. When import the time delivery, I receive overall all the order 15 quantity. I order 15 quantity sampai. But the second order I order 20. But only arrive 15 lah. So actually ada 5 lagi order yang tak sampai, betul tak? Okay. If I do this transaction and then save, what will happen to my purchase order? First you, this one costing value, okay. First you see ah. When I go back to the supplier order, either 312 or 311, when I click inside, see what is the alert? The bill has been export partially or fully. Means this bill already transfer, not transfer, export to the supplier bill. This one just now. Okay, so I cannot do changes on this bill. Why cannot do changes? Because you already import 15. Then suddenly I pergi tukar 16. Boleh pula tukar 16. Tukar 16. And then you boleh cakap, you boleh complain, eh, I order from supplier 16th mah. Then it's wrong already. We want to avoid this kind of things. That's why kita tak allow change punya. You order 15, means you punya record ordering is 15 lah. Okay. Okay. So this is the bill, the oil we add just now. Remember, both bill 311 and 312, we receive 15 quantity from each, even though the P0312 actually original is 20. Okay. When we want to import this bill again, can we import again? Yes. Why? Still have back order. Why is it said back order? Back order means the leftover belum import punya balance. Okay. Now, I create lagi delivery order on 10 of. See, just now, when I key in 9 hari bulan, I boleh nampak 2 bill. I key in 10 hari bulan, why I nampak 1 bill saja? PO0311 dated at is before this document, before this date. Yeah. Is before this one. So expected I should be able to see, right? But then why I do this delivery order on 10, I still cannot, I cannot see for PO311 already, because the PO0311 is already fully import. Semua 15 quantity you already import. So no more balance you mau import mah. So tak ada yang, sudah tak ada order yang tak sampai. Semua order sudah sampai. Okay. Why I still can see this one? Original just now for this is 20. Yes, I import 15 already, left 5 aja lah. Okay, now I click here. See, automatically it show 5 sahaja. Automatically quantity akan jadi 5 saja. This 5 is actually back order for this PO for Apple punya products. Can get ah? Boleh ah? So, I tak mau import this one lah. Ini saja. Okay. I letak dekat sini ya. PO0311 product A mah. Apple produk A. Ni berapa quantity? 15. This one? 20. Then for this one, I import buat 2-2. Zero, zero, four, six. Berapa? 15. This one berapa? 15. So my back order. Sorry ya. So once I import this I import this bill to this PO. The back order for this one is how much? Zero. No leftover. This one? Five. So this one is what we call as back order lah. Leftover not yet imported or not yet being imported to another document. So this back order is belong to this PO, respective PO. Zero means this one no back order. Five back order for product Apple under this document. Okay. I'm giving
can repeat what I said just now? Just now it's like I can't hear the sound.
Until which part?
Done for the explanation to the back order.
This one, the final explanation. This one, this part ke?
Already done. This one already done.
Oh, this one ah. Actually, I say I will give one scenario to test your all punya understanding.
Okay.
Okay. Example, I have these two purchase order. This purchase order, PO01 and PO02. So, respectively, each of this document, I have apple, berry and cocoa products inside. So, the quantity is like this one. Okay. Now, I import to DO for PO01. I import from PO01. So what I import? Okay. So what I import? 10 units of this one, 5, and then 5. So now, until this part, what is the back order? For this, this is the PO. This is the product inside the PO and its quantity. Now I already import one to DO01. I import from which document? PO01. For which product? Apple, berry, and cocoa. What is the quantity? 10, 5, 5. So now, once I do these transactions, what will be my back order for PO01 apple berry cocoa and PO02. Okay. Sui. Five. N. Tongseng.
20.
20. Tong Seng, you can hear me or not? Ah?
Just now cannot.
Now can. Okay. So now the back order for this PO 02. Apple, you answer 20. Berry?
Berry 15. Cocoa 25.
Cocoa 25. Okay. Hey, sorry. So cocoa is 25. Oh, correct. This is the back order for these products once I do this import. Okay. Want to ask, what is the back order for DO01? Anyone can answer? Senang lo, this one lo. Because this DO I import from this PO, betul. So this DO for apple products is 10 quantity. Berry is 5 quantity, cocoa is 5 quantity. So this DO can still be import to invoice. So it still have back order for this delivery order. So what is the balance not yet imported? 10 for apple, 5 for berry, 5 for cocoa for this DO01. Okay, can. Okay, now I do another import. I import to invoice 01. For which document? Now I give this one I import like this one Big size can see or not Can. Now I want to ask, what is the back order? I'm giving Hina. You all give me answer inside the WhatsApp group now. What is the value for A, B, C, sorry, D, E, F, B, F, G, H? A is how much, B is how much. You all give me your own answer, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. What is the value? I give another 4 minutes, then kita tengok. If you can answer this, means you understand already the back order.
actually, I lupa tanya, you punya laptop sudah okay tak? Still tak. Is your laptop sudah okay tak?
Sudah.
Dek, macam mana dia okay?
High
tech.
Yang
buat. Oh, dia buat apa tak tahulah.
Sama
lah.
Tapi saya tak masuk.
Apa I check tengok dia punya answer tu. Suyi dengan Wen ada answer lain ke? Dia ada different, sama. Sama ke, tak sama ke?
I don't know the G and H.
G and H. Okay.
Saya rasa itu invoice zero kan sebab sudah import dan maksudnya dia sudah takde. So saya letak zero.
Okay. I akan explain kenapa dia zero. Betul, you all punya answer zero is betul. Tapi I akan explain kenapa dia is zero. Okay. So so you all punya answer is correct. So basically when you boleh answer this this punya kind of case, you boleh faham already to back order. So I import to invoice by this one. Why I punya DO is still remain as zero. You answer dekat sini berapa tadi ya? E is belong to 10. F is 5. Kalau kita tengok dekat sini, still sama dengan yang ni punya, betul tak? Still sama dengan ini. Why sama? Is due to this one dekat sini dia tak ada import, totally tak ada import. So back order tak akan kacau. Dia tak akan impact you punya back order from this DO. Unless I letak dekat sini, I ada import example 2. So now only baru dia akan affect I punya quantity dekat sini is 8. Boleh lah. Think you all can understand already lah. So this one tadi you all answer 15. B is 20. This impact by this punya import. So all is imported 5, 5, 5, 5. You tak akan tengok daripada sini. You akan tengok daripada previous punya back order, betul tak? So dia akan impact dekat sini is 5. Import 5. From back order 20 akan left 15. From back order 15 akan import 5. 10. 20. Then dekat sini pun samalah. 0. 0. Why? Sebab ini semua import sama dengan back order. Kalau you tengok dekat sini, kalau you tengok based on original document, memang you akan dapat ada balance, ada back order. But that one is not the correct way. You kena check all imported document for that PO. Since ada import pergi DO, ada import pergi invoice, bila you total this one and you total this one, sudah sama dengan sini punya. So no more back order. Can ah? Okay. You all answer this one as 0 and 0. Why 0 and 0? Okay. Bear in mind, invoice dia tak akan import pergi mana-mana document. Invoice is the final document, invoicing. So dia tak akan ada back order. That's why back order invoice 0, 0 and 0. Okay? So good. You all boleh understand itu back order. So kita sudah cover untuk back order and import while we discover on this supplier punya side. Okay, supplier order, supplier customer order, any questions? Actually dia sama, just the process dia line entry lah. The process is sama.
Okay. Can explain again why the invoice is zero?
Invoice is zero, why invoice is zero? Okay. Normally in system, kita akan buat purchase order. First document we are going to do the purchase order. Then this purchase order will be imported to delivery order. This is the normal lah, normal transactions. Then once you already have your delivery order, then only you will have your invoice. Let's say this purchase order 10 quantity. This 10 quantity, quantity will be imported to this delivery order. Import 10. So this one will have back order. If I say I import 5, then this will have back order 5. Okay, so delivery order can it be imported to another document? Yes, can. To which document? Invoice. So let's say this delivery order, this invoice import delivery order. Three quantity. So delivery order will have back order because I ada 5. I import from this purchase order. Sorry ya. Lah senang sikit tengok difference dia. I import from purchase order 4 quantity. So back order for this purchase order is how much? 6. Back order 6 lah. Then this one I import for that time. How much is back order for my delivery order? Four. Back order is still four. Okay. Then I import this DO to this one, from this one to this one. This delivery order can be imported to invoice. That's why I still have back order. That's why I still have back order for. So let's say I import DO quantity 3. This invoice, this 3 quantity, I can import to another document or not? Long Seng?
Cannot,
because this invoice is the final document that you will issue. So, you know, no back order already. Dia tak ada back order yang you boleh import pergi another document. So, automatically, we will treat as 0 back order. We will treat automatically for invoice document, we will treat back order as 0. That's why when you view reportings, when we view reportings, under this supplier bill, you will see is DO back order only. DO back order, I'd say as DO back order because the document that you will see inside is from the delivery order only. Okay? Can ah? Long Seng?
Can.
Okay, good. Okay, so any other questions regarding this? QA sini? Okay. Clear apa tu back order, how to count you punya back order, how to have the expected on your back order number, then how to do the import. Can? Okay. If no questions, I will discuss about this one just in brief lah. Okay. Normally when we do transactions, alamak tak ada discount. I open setting first. Still remember this setting, when we set setting at here, it will impact your user or not. It will impact which user, your own user only for this one. Oh, ada.